Hey, and this is part two. I think there's going to be one more part. I think that'll cover it. The porta can deer blind that I made. Let me go in here and open the door up. I put a window in it right here. I think I said something about it in my first video. I was going to, but I blacked it out. I wasn't no sense in going all the way up to the top with it. This is Flex Seal that I sprayed on it. Remember that shelf I told you I put there? Put padding carpet on it and whatnot. There's the toilet paper holder. You can use that to dry your scope or whatever. Cell phone got wet, whatever, you can dry it off. But still got the skylight in there. Got the hook for the hang your binoculars or whatever in it. Put the 3/4 inch plywood floor in it. Put the carpet in there to kind of cut down on the noise. That's why we sprayed this right here, to try to cut down on the dampening of the noise. I was going to put carpet on it, but decided to go Flex Seal instead. But you come inside here, and of course you can pull the door too and latch it, and that'll keep it from rattling in case there's any high winds or whatever. Move your chair back around where it needs to go and sit down there just like that. Look all the way around. I'll be able to look that down that way, a field or what, it woods or whatever, same here. But look at here what I did with this windows. I was going to put latches and all that kind of stuff, but I took some fiberglass rods and just made me some little kickstands, and it just come right down. And I balled that out, made a little socket so that this tip could sit in it pretty good. But look at there, rain last night, but drier than a popcorn fart in here. Same on this side, same way. But this window right here, I was, because it's rounded at the front, kind of goes round like that, so it'd be kind of hard. I'd have a split in the middle, and potential rain could come in and, you know, get this part of it wet or whatever. So I put a bend in it. I don't know if you can see it going right here or not. I bent it, but watch how it folds down. I'll put that out. Look at here. See how they crisscross over on each other? And then when you go to push it up, look at there. So you never get rain in here. And you're, so that's that. Got the same thing. I put a little ball socket so that this, when it goes in there, it won't slip out. And I put a little hole right down in here for it to stick down in there, so it won't fall. But yeah, in the winter time, it's extremely cold. I can leave my windows down, put a little buddy heater in there. I've got ventilation out here, so any fumes or whatever, CO2 or carbon dioxide, can get out, or carbon monoxide, let's say. Let's see. I think that's pretty much going to be about, oh, gun rest. So if you laid it there, you know, the gun could potentially slip and fall and clang over. But you put that gun right in here, and it kind of shaped it where it'd be easy to access it into that spot and rest it down on the floor. And yep. I'm going to go outside and see if I can't show you a little bit of the outside. This little folding chair would be perfect to get in and out of. So, I still want to put some treatment on these 2x4s, or 2x3s, let's call it. But here's that I was telling you about. how it overlaps each other when it goes to close. See that? Pretty cool. But I'm gonna do a follow-up video once we get it down there and get it set. But that's it, y'all. It see that natural camouflage on it? That's algae built up on it. And I had people say, "You gonna clean that thing up?" And I said, "Absolutely not. That's natural camo." And it doesn't matter once it's in the woods, the critters and creatures and deer and whatever, they're going to get used to seeing it there all the time anyway, and nothing ever happens. But I could be in it one time and get whatever, because they get comfortable. If they see something all the time, they get comfortable with it. So, all right, remember, subscribe, like, share, subscribe, and follow this, because I got one more part coming. Maybe two. I don't know. But this is part two. So it's an idea, y'all. You know, you can get one of these porta cans. It's, you know, they practically giving them away once they're old and outdated like this. You can get them pretty cheap. So it's something for wintertime, man. You get out there and it's raining. Let's say it's 34 degrees, raining. Too cold to set out in it, but yet not too cold for it to, you know, let's say snow, but it's raining. That cold rain, boy, that'll get to your bone quicker than snow will. Snow will bounce right off, but that rain will get you wet and get down your bone. But all right, stay tuned. More to come.